Blue works.
Here's trouble.
What was that?
Found
him. Better in our hands anyway.
Telling you, joining Skinny Malone's crew was the best decision we've ever made. Look at this place.
I still say Malone's weak. We caught that detective snooping around, and what does he do? Locks him up. Like he ain't got the balls to just kill him.
Well, don't let his new girl hear that. She'll start swinging that... Huh?
Found him!
Hey!
Come on. Hey!
We're not alone here.
can't pick this.
So I got a question. Why the hell would anyone build a vault out of a subway station? This place is like the opposite of airtight.
Because they weren't planning to use it, but the...
What was that? Shape than I expected.
Going in there, Valentine. Feeling hungry? Want a snack?
Keep talking, meathead. It'll give Skinny Malone more time to think about how he's gonna bump you off.
Don't give me that crap, Valentine. You know nothing, you got nothing.
Really? I saw him writing your name down in that black book of his. Lousy, cheating card shark, I think were his exact words. Then he struck the name across three times.
Three strikes? In the Black Book? But I never...
Shit!
Where'd that come from?
Locked out of the terminal, don't worry. The system will reset itself. Just give it a minute.
Gotta love the irony of the reverse damsel in distress scenario. Question is, why did our heroine risk life and limb for an old private eye?
What are you?
Told you, I'm a detective. Look, I know the skin and the metal parts ain't comforting, but it's not important right now. The only thing that matters is why you went to all this trouble to cut me loose.
My baby's missing. His name's Sean. He was kidnapped, but I don't know who took him or where they went.
Missing kid, huh? Well, you came to the right man, not the right place. I've been cooped up in here for weeks. Turns out the runaway daughter I came here to find wasn't kidnapped. She's Skinny Malone's new flame. And she's got a mean streak. Anyway, you got troubles, and I'm glad to help. But now ain't the time. Let's blow this joint. Then we'll talk.
Hell yeah.
Malone's crew here used to be small time, muscled out of the old neighborhood by bigger plans. Now this place. Don't know what happened to the previous owner. But they're not exactly around to charge rent. Empty vault. Perfect hideout.
This is Vault Tech Interview number 03 for the position of Overseer for Vault 114. Interview subject, Benjamin Beasley. Mr. Beasley, as Overseer of Vault 114, how would you settle a disagreement between two of your vault residents?
Well, I would obviously take it through the proper channels. Assuming neither of their requests were against the law, of course. This is, of course, assuming that the conflict had already gone through all the other members of the Vault's Residence Council that I plan on organizing.
Vault Residence Council, you say?
Yes, of course. People need government. They yearn for it. I think it's a civic duty of every red-blooded American patriot to serve the...
Yes, I think we have everything we need here. Thank you for your time.
Oh, already? Well, I look forward to hearing from you soon.
Yes, I'm sure you will. Please make sure to fill out your non-disclosure agreement on your way out. This is Vault Tech Interview number 21 for the position of Overseer for Vault 114. Interview subject, Kimberly Weiss. Hello, Mrs. Weiss.
How do you do? And may I just say what an honor it is to even be considered for the position of Overseer. Ever since I was a little girl in mock government, I dreamed that one day I would have the opportunity to lead a community to greatness. My teachers all told me I had leadership potential, and without my guidance as student council vice president, those bake sales surely would have failed. Just the thought of being able to organize and run this small group, to show them a better way, to lead them to a future so bright that they...
My goodness. Looks like we're out of time.
What? We just started!
Yes, yes. Thank you. If you could just send the next candidate in as you leave.
Oh, of course. Did I mention I was head of my debate team?
I'm sure you did. Thank you. This is Vault Tech interview number 87 for the position of overseer for Vault 114. The candidate has refused to give his real name and has only provided the name Soup Can Harry.
That's right. I ain't telling you nothing. My name is the name I call myself, not the rank and number the government brands on me. No, sir.
Fascinating, Mr. Soup Can. Would you mind telling me why you're distrustful of the government?
I've seen what they do. Gum up the works with red tape and bureaucracy, take every hard-earned cent and use it to fund their Illuminati, Freemason sex parties. I'm a free man. I should be able to live as I see fit. My taxes pay for them streets and alleys and dumpsters. I'll sleep where I want.
Sir, according to this, you haven't paid taxes in many years.
I seen the back of them Abraxo boxes. Not for consumption? Don't you tell me what to do. I'll eat what I want.
Sir, you may just be the perfect candidate. How would you like to be the new overseer for Vault 114?
I ain't wearing no goddamn tie. Or pants.
Scared?
Point the way. Don't mind the clutter. What you got?
huh? Well, it gets the job done. Bad for whoever cleans up the floors. This door's on the...
Hey, Valentine.
I know you have a case you want solved, but underground and surrounded is not the best place to talk. Almost got it. There we are. Hell of a lot easier to do when the lock isn't on the other side.
Who's there?
What? The hell?
Very funny. Get back to work. What I saw.
You have nothing.
That tickled it.
That's one way to get that coolant pumping.
Got a nice pair of cement shoes for you. You lost her, huh?
More stairs? Who built this?
Shouldn't hide.
Fitness
Ain't
instructor.
Very courageous of you.
Scratch one off the list. Ran off.
Where'd you go?
You say the word. Help yourself.
Skinny Malone and the rest of his boys are waiting for us somewhere. The name's, ironic, but don't let that fool you. He's dangerous. Another locked door. Shouldn't be too hard. Okay, I got it. Gotta hear Big... Fat footsteps on the other side. Once we step through this door, get ready for anything.
What are you doing? You come into my house, shoot up my guys? You have any idea how much this is gonna set me back?
I wouldn't be here if it weren't for your two-timing dame, Skinny. You ought to tell her to write home more often.
Oh, poor little Valentine. Ashamed you got beat up by a girl. I'll just run back home to Daddy, shall I?
Should've left it alone, Nikki. This ain't the old neighborhood. In this vault, I'm king of the castle, you hear me? And I ain't letting some private dick shut us down now that I finally got a good thing going.
I told you we should've just killed him! But then you had to get all sentimental. All that stupid crap about the old times.
Darla, I'm handling this! Skinny Malone's always got things under control.
Oh, yeah? Then what's this lady doing here, huh? Valentine must have brought her here to rub us all out.
Darla, listen to me. You have a home to go back to. You don't want to throw your life away with these thugs.
You're right! What am I doing? I've gotten all mixed up.
Darla! Where are you going?
Home, Skinny. Where I should have been all this time. This is goodbye for us.
Oh, come on, Nikki. You cost me my men. Now you and your friend cost me my girl?
My friend here just did you a favor, Skinny. You always did have bad taste in women. Now that she's not around to feed that temper of yours, maybe you'll see sense and let us walk. You still owe me for 2 weeks in the hole.
You smug, overconfident ass. Get out of here! All right, you get to the count of 10. I still see your face after that. I'm gunning both of you down.
We better get out of here, fast.
1, 2, 3.
Commonwealth sky. Never thought anything so naturally ominous could end up looking so inviting. Thanks for getting me out. How did you know where to find me, anyway? Not many people knew where I went.
Your secretary, Ellie. She sent me.
She did? I should give her a raise. Now, you mentioned something about your son, Sean, and how he went missing. I want you to come to my office in Diamond City. Give me all the details. Besides, I think you've earned a chance to sit down and clear your head.
I'll meet you there.
See you in Diamond City.
If you want to give me a second printing press while you're at it.
Heads up.
Looking for something specific?
Over here.
Uh-huh.
Look alive.
Yep.
Look alive.
Can do. How are you?
Let's trade.
Go ahead.
Can we trade a few things?
Go ahead.
I want to trade a few things.
Of course.
I just want to trade a few things.
Sure.
I just need to trade gear with you.